What's going on, everyone? So just wanted to update on what's going on. I won't have a lot of stuff happening quite yet. I'm still waiting on a lot of parts to come in. I have been posting some, trying to get like a poll on RGH 1, 2, or 3, just what the general public seems to, which one they would pick if they all looked the same. So far, not really anybody said RGH3. A lot of people said 1 and 2. I could see that more in the nostalgia side of things. Especially when I added in JTAG. Everyone said JTAG, obviously. So that's actually what we have. Now this one here is just a random Falcon. I had it here for the photo. This is our RGH 1.2. And then this is actually just a Jasper. Over here we have an old Xenon. And then underneath that is the RGH3 with the Sonos speaker installed. And this one is actually half bricked. This one does have Aurora. It was working. I swapped out the fan with the Talus Moon fan just to try it out. And then it stopped booting after that. So I'm going to have to reflash the NAND, but I still want to take the whole motherboard out, kind of check the solder points and everything on that. But anyway, because of the success of the last two auctions, I've been able to start accumulating a lot of these parts. And I didn't really plan on getting one of each, but that's kind of how it worked out. And I got an awesome deal on some of these. I mean, one of these was $100. The JTAG is not here yet. I do have a JTAG on the way. And then, like I said, the RGH2 is over here. So we got 1, 2, 3, and a JTAG. Now, the JTAG, I already have plans to put it in the Ruby Red shell. I want this one to have all the cool little things going on. The JTAG is actually a Zephyr motherboard with the original Blades dashboard. So that's a really cool build. It's going to be kind of a... It's going to be the one that I'll do after the 1 and the 2, at least. But it will not be cheap. This is going to be something. I want to have all the cool old parts that you just can't find anymore on there. Just cool, rare stuff. So that's what's happening with that. The 3, I'm going to put on hold for a while. Like I said, I want to kind of figure that one out and make sure I have plenty of time to test it out and make sure it's all good. Here, like I said, is the RGH1. Now, I really wanted to do a dark side build to the R2-D2 Slim that I did. However, that's what I'm going to be doing now. So, little sneak peek, got some decals here. Doesn't mean these are the ones I'm going to use. Probably will definitely use that one, actually. But yeah, we're going to do a Yoda and a Vader build. And part of that is I found an awesome deal on faceplates. I explained this in the last video. I got the Yoda one, and I got a Vader one. It's just not here yet. Really what I'm doing today is just explaining the builds, and I have a whole bunch of cleaning to do from all the other projects here and up in the game room. So I gotta clean and reorganize all that stuff before I start tearing apart more things. Even though that's what I did here with the RGH3, and then I had this one out just to kind of test different water blocks. Because here's part of the problem. The RGH2 disk drive won't open, in the RGH1. I was told by this guy he doesn't know if it works or not, which means it may or may not be the one that goes with this motherboard. If that's the case, there's nothing we can do. However, they should be easy fixes. Refurbish the rubber band in there and just kind of clean the lenses up and everything. They should be okay. However, I want to play off the fact that the disk drive may not work, and both of these, the 1 and the 2, is what I'm using for the Vader and Yoda build, by the way. Both have the XE menu, and we'll have both of them already have all the Grand Theft Auto, all the Call of Duties, and there's still like 200 gigabytes of free space of stuff. So basically, digital console. Take out the disk drive completely. The reason I wouldn't do that with the 3 is because this one also has a flashed DVD drive, so it could actually burn games. So that one's going to be a cool build for later if we can get it figured out. But anyway, I had to decide between the 1 and the 2, which one I'm going to do Yoda and which one Vader. The one kind of struck me more as the dark side because it has the, it has a mod chip, it has lifetime and a couple stealth servers. Very cool going on here. This one's just an RGH2. It's got the XE menu, can play all the games on the hard drive, and that's about it. So, like I said, this one will have the Vader faceplate, and what I did today, I actually got back from Hobby Lobby. I want to do more solid paint on these two builds, but I don't want to just use the boring plain colors they got at like Walmart or Ace Hardware or any of that. Hobby Lobby has these hobbyist paints that are meant for small model cars and stuff like that, and these are actually all metallics, so this is like a graphite looking thing, and these will obviously be for Vader. And then we got this metallic red, this green here that's metallic, and this is a metallic bronze, and that'll be for the Yoda build. So I got this stuff ready. As of now, I'm debating water cooling. Like I said, I can remove the DVD drive, which will actually allow me to water cool a FAT without the XSPC water block, because I can use this one, which technically is the slimmest one I can find. It still doesn't fit under the DVD drive, but if it's not going to be in there, I've got plenty of room to put all this stuff in here. Shouldn't have any radiator sticking out or anything like that. It should look really nice. Now, which one do I do? Well, as of now, I'm planning on actually water cooling the Vader build. So this will be the pricier one, and then this one is going to be air-cooled. But because we don't need the DVD drive, I'm going to put all kinds of extra fans in there. I'm planning on putting a fan controller where the disk drive would be. It'll have a cold cathode kit, all kinds of cool stuff, Talus Moon fan. And then this one will have, I'm still kind of working out which blocks and stuff to use. Like I said, this one would work. The only problem is, because of all the capacitors around the CPU, there's no orientation I could put this one on that side. So I would need a block like this, however this bracket is way too big. So I'm also today going to see how easy it'll be to just trim off the ends of this and then drill a new hole right here on all four corners. And if I can do that, that's going to be awesome because these are $15. So I could get a bunch of these, and as long as I don't need a disk drive, boom, that one there, they come in clear and black. But yeah, like I said, I'm still figuring the water cooling stuff out. So we're probably going to work on the Yoda build this weekend, which is in a couple days. We'll start cutting out the fan. This one will have a big 200 millimeter fan. I actually have it under this mess of stuff right here. A fluid bearing fan. Now this one has red LEDs, but I'm just going to take those out. And then I want to put a bank of fans across the top, make the hard drive custom so that it can allow a lot more airflow through it. And that'll be an extra exhaust. We'll have the Talus Moon fans out the back, big fan up top, and then we can fit two of these heat sinks, one on the GPU, one on the CPU, just like this. And yeah, that should allow plenty of cooling instead of that tiny one that has to fit under the DVD drive. Other than that, yeah, that's where we're at right now. I just wanted to kind of update. Like I said, I'm still waiting on a lot of parts, so some of them just take quite a while to come in, and I can't really, like, don't want to cut this one yet until I have the fan so I can measure it out, things like that. So, but yeah, I plan on at least cutting that water block, seeing if we can get that to work. I gotta clean up all this stuff before I start tearing these apart. And then I also, well, once I do that, then I need to tear both of these apart, take the disk drives out, see if I can clean them, get them to work, and yeah, decide what we're doing from there. So let me know which one you're most excited about, Darth Vader, Yoda, or down the road, the Ruby Red Shell JTAG Blades, or eventually the RGH3. Now, another reason I want to put that on hold, it has the R2-D2 noises. I was kind of bummed out, honestly, because the guy said it was Chewbacca, but I don't think he spoke English that well. It seemed kind of broken English. So maybe he just thought that was Chewbacca sounds. But I have never really programmed one of those, so I want to mess with that. Maybe do like sounds from Transformers, get one of the cool Transformer faceplates and do a build with that one, or something. I've always wanted to do like a Fast and Furious or something like that, Need for Speed themed build. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Look forward to these projects coming up. One more thing. My PS2, I am planning on cleaning this up and putting it up for sale soon, because I kind of just want to get a backwards compatible PS3 and have all that in one. And I don't really use this to its full potential. This is actually a Infinity version 1.99, and obviously Ghost Case. So the only thing is, it doesn't seem to want to play blue discs, but other than that, it has worked great. This is a knockoff controller, but this will come with it, as well as a nice wired controller that's not all chewed up. It's actually was pretty much new when I got it, so I'm doing that. And one last thing, the PS3 water cooled. I actually plan on selling this one. We're going to jailbreak it, make sure it's got all kinds of stuff on it, water cool it, and I want to sell it. Like I said, I'm looking for a PS3 FAT that's fully backwards compatible, so I don't have to mess with the PS2 FATs or anything like that. And I can still jailbreak one of those. But, yeah. Look forward to that. It'll be the Chrome Shell. Whatever custom firmware. I'm not familiar with the latest ones, but we'll just load the hard drive up. And I think I want to keep this fan. We'll have to put a radiator. I want to find one that'll fit underneath this, because it was designed to have the fan and radiator on top. And it already has holes back here, so I want to figure out a reservoir that's going to already cover that up. I don't want to have to get another one of these shells. But, yeah, so look forward to that as well. So the PS2, like I said, I got lots of parts I'm waiting on. And the other stuff, especially water-cooled, is going to take quite a while to get all the builds done. I really want to do the Yoda and Vader and have them done together before selling them. Maybe even just sell them at the same time. But, yeah, lots of planning and stuff goes into that. So, in the meantime, while I'm waiting for parts and other things with those builds, this is one I don't really have to do anything for. It's already cut. It's already got the water block. I just got to do some software stuff and kind of reinstall everything. And same with the PS2. That one, I mean, is just ready to go. I think one of the memory card doors kind of came off. I'll just have to repair that. And yeah, so we'll have a PS2, PS3, and the PS4 is also still listed as well. So we'll have all three up there. But that is about it. No, it's not. One last thing. As you know, this stuff was all in the Mega Loop build. And the last thing we saw, this, everything was working. However, the one reservoir was leaking a little bit, so I had to drain it again. However, that's around when I found out we may be relocating soon for my fiance's job, so I didn't want to put this all together just to drain it out again, because it kind of is sort of built into the shelf the way the tubing is. So I'm like, I'm not even going to mess with it if I have to move everything, and I can circle back to doing something with this. So yeah, that's where we're at with this. Plus, I'm going to take this apart while I'm cleaning up all of the stuff on those tables. I'm going to clean that up and disassemble this, and obviously we're going to use at least one or two of the pumps from there for the builds, as well as a few other things, lighting and maybe reservoirs, flow meters, things like that. So anyway, let me know which system you are most excited about. PS2, PS3, PS4, which is probably not it because it's still for sale. Or the Yoda, Vader, Ruby Red Shell. That's it for now. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next video.